This lesson is using sample data and modifying a list box. In this lesson, you'll learn how to add sample data to your project and style the list box that contains this data to fit the needs of your project. Expression Blend makes it easy to prototype, build, and test applications that are data connected without needing to access the live data files. You can use the data panel to generate sample data or even import sample data from an XML file. The sample data is available to controls on your artboard at the time you design your projects. So to get a better sense of how this works, let's go ahead and create a new data source by clicking on the Data tab and then choosing Add Sample Data Source. From the menu, choose Define New Sample Data, and we should give this a good name. In this particular case, you're going to be creating a sample portfolio site. So let's call this Portfolio Data. Then click OK. As soon as you do that, you'll get a new data collection. Now, by default, this data collection contains two generic properties, Property 1 and Property 2. You'll rename these shortly. However, before you do that, you'll add two additional properties. Click on the Add Simple Property button, and then click again to give you four properties. You're now going to rename these properties to make them more specific. So click on Property 1, and then double-click on that label. And for the first property, we'll call this Portfolio Image. The second will be Portfolio Site. The third will be Portfolio Email. And the last will be Portfolio Rank. Now that we've labeled them, we need to make sure that the type of property represents the name. So click on the menu to the right of Portfolio Email, and we can see that this is a string type. Click on the Format menu and choose Email Address. For Portfolio Image, click on the menu, and for this type, click on the menu and choose Image. For Portfolio Rank, click on the menu, and then change this type from String to Number. And for the last property, Portfolio Site, click on this menu, choose String again, and for Format, choose Website URL. So we have four property values available to us. Realize that these are part of a collection. So what we'll now do is create a list box in our artboard based on this data. Now the best way to do this is to click and drag the collection onto your artboard. You'll see a pop-up here, and by default this will create a list box control. We can expand that list box and see all our data within. I'm going to move this off to the left for a moment. One thing I do want to point out is that all of these individual properties can actually be added by themselves. So for example, if you click Portfolio Image and drag it onto your artboard, you'll get a list box with just the images. For our purposes, however, we're going to use all four properties, so we can delete this one. So by itself, this is pretty cool. We now have a list box, which is populated with live data. And if I choose Project, Run Project, we can see that this list box has built-in functionality based on the template. So I can scroll through the list box. I can hover over the items, I can click and hold down on them, and all of this behavior is controlled by the templates based on this list box. However, the first thing that you'll want to do is customize this list box. So let's take a look at how to do that by closing our browser and returning to Blend. Now the style of this list box as well as the layout of the items within are all controlled by templates. To access these, let's right-click on the list box, choose Edit Additional Templates, Edit Generated Items. From the submenu that appears, choose Edit Current. And we can see here that within this template, there's a stack panel. This stack panel currently contains all of our data, the text block, the image, and the two other text blocks. By default, a stack panel aligns items vertically. So what we'll do here is convert this from a stack panel to a grid container. In order to do that, let's right-click on the stack panel and choose Change Layout Type Grid. Now that this container is a grid, we can begin to rearrange the items within. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom in here so we can see this a little better. The first thing I'll do is expand the grid. So click on the edge of the grid and expand it to the right, and then expand your grid. Now one of the benefits of grids is the ability to add columns. So I'm going to place my cursor on the top of the grid, and we can see a yellow line going from the top down to the bottom. So I'm going to place this boundary to the right of my image, and this defines two columns, one on the left, one on the right. I'm going to keep the image in the left column, and I'm going to move my other content into the right column. At this point, I can simply do that by clicking on the objects and moving them around. So first, I'll click on the website text block and move it up and to the right. I'm not going to worry too much about the size of the list box at this point. I'll then click on the email address, which is the top text block, and drag it down. And then finally, I'll click on the number and drag that underneath. Finally, in order to adjust for the remaining space, I'll click back on the grid element and then move this up slightly. Now you'll notice that as I do that, the image automatically scales. That's not a problem. We can simply click on that image and then click and drag it to the right to expand. Now let's exit this template view by clicking on the ListBox breadcrumb navigation. Now in order to make up for the fact that the content is extending beyond the ListBox, I'll simply extend it by clicking and dragging. Now let's say we wanted to change the layout of this entire list box. So rather going from top to bottom, I'd like to make this go from left to right. In order to do that, I need to edit the layout of this template. To do this, I'll right-click on the list box, choose Edit Additional Templates, and then Edit Layout of Items. I have to create an empty resource, so I'll choose that option, and then click OK. Now these entire sections here are defined by a stack panel. So to change the orientation of this stack panel, select it, click on your Properties panel, and then scroll down and locate the Layout section. Again, the default orientation is vertical, so let's click on this menu and choose Horizontal. With the layout set to horizontal, we now have the items moving from left to right. Again, we need to exit the template view of this by clicking the ListBox breadcrumb navigation. And we also need to modify the size of the list box. Let's do that by shortening the height. So now we're in good shape, but let's say that we want to modify the images within this list box to represent portfolios. Let's go back to our data tab, and then let's go back to our collection. You can do this by clicking Edit Sample Values. And we now see the sample values within our data. One thing to point out here is that you can adjust the number of records in your data by clicking and dragging within this field here. So perhaps we might only have 6 records. And if we want to change the source of our portfolio image, we can click on the Change Property Type menu. And we can see here an empty field for location. Let's click Browse. And then we'll navigate to our Asset folder. And we'll choose this folder, Portfolio Thumbnails, and we'll select that folder. So we now have new images, and it's also worth pointing out that you can modify the values of anything within this column. So for example, the portfolio rank. Rather than starting from 10 and going to 15, we can simply double-click on these values and change them. Once we're done with that, let's click OK. And now we're in good shape. Let's take a final look by choosing Project, Run Project. Of course, we could continue modifying the styles. However, for now, you've learned how to add sample data to your project, as well as style the list box that contains this data to fit the needs of your project.